let's see what is statistic. Okay, now statistic, chapter 6 statistic. Okay, for standard 10 in max 1. Let's see what is statistic in short. Okay, just we are going to see the definition. Statistic is the science of average and estimates. Okay, what it is? Average and estimates. So statistic is the science of average and estimates. It is the study of collection, analysis, interpretations and organization of data for specific purpose. Is it clear? You can see here. Okay, in PPT you can see how the data are represented. Okay, so we should know what is statistic in short. That is, it is average and estimates. It is the study of collection, analysis, interpretation and organization of data for specific purpose. Is it clear? Yes or no? Okay. So we will recall what we have learned in a 9th standard. Okay, just see. So mean we have learned. So first of all, we should know what is mean. Correct, na? So mean gives average of the data. Mean gives average of the data. All data is given equal importance in this. Every data is important. It is used in each case where all data is important. Okay. Example, let's see. Average salary of employees in an organization. Correct? And suppose we want to find out the height of a 10th standard, or we want to find the average marks, whatever you have got in 10th standard. Okay. So we are going to see then median. Median is used to find the middle most value. Which value? Middle most value. Median is what? It is used to find middle most value. Okay. It is used to determine a point from where 50% of data is more and 50% data is less. Then only it becomes middle most value. Okay. Yes. It is used where extreme cases can be ignored. Example, to find the performance of a cricketer, where his worst and best extreme performance can be ignored to give his consistent performance. Can you remember what is the best performance of Sachin Tendulkar? Tell me first. No one is writing. To find the performance of a cricketer where his worst and best extreme performance can be ignored to give his consistent performance. Okay. Okay, next, mode. Mode is used where we need to find the most frequent data. Example, if we need to find, if we need to find the most favorite subject of a student in a given class, mode can be used. Okay, mode means maximum value, correct? Now let's see, we have seen data in this definition. So let's see what is data. In statistic, the term data is used to refer to information. What is that? It is information. It is information that has been collected and recorded for the purpose of specific projects, and it could be either qualitative or quantitative type. Okay, again I'm repeating, in statistic the term data is used to refer to information that has been collected and recorded for the purpose of specific projects, and it could be either qualitative or quantitative type. Okay, so data, group data and ungrouped data. So in that data also there is a group data or ungrouped data. Is it clear? Okay, sure, up to here. Okay, let's see range. In 9th standard you have learned. What is range? Range of data is the difference between the maximum and the minimum value of the observation. Means maximum minus minimum. Okay, that is the range. Maximum value minus minimum value of the observation is called as a range. Is it clear? Now, tables that shows the frequency of different values in the given data is called as a frequency distribution table. Everyone remember what is a frequency distribution table. So in the table which shows the frequency of different values in the given data is called as a frequency distribution table. Is it clear? Up to here is clear? Okay, type fast. If you understood up to here, type it fast. Yes, Bhumi. Okay, let's see now. Class. The grouping used to group the value in a given data is called as a classes or class interval. Correct? The grouping used to group the values in given data are called as a classes or class interval. The number of values that each class contain is called the class size or class width. So all these points you have learned in 9th standard. Again, I'm revising you, so you should know what is class interval, class size or class width. The number of values that each class contain is called as a class size or class width. Suppose class is 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40. So what is the class width of this class? Yes, Ria, correct. The class width is 10, like this. The lower value in a class is called as a lower class limit. And the higher value in a class is called the upper class value. Yes or not? Swati. Okay, let's see again. Okay, so you can see here class mark. We are going to say class mark. Okay. Class mark of a class is the mid value of the two limits of that class. Is it clear? Class mark of a class is the mid value of the two limits of that class. Is it clear? Now you can see here class mark. You can see first of all the class, okay? 15, 19, 20, 24, 25, 29, 30, 34, 35, 39. Okay? Now what is the, add 15 plus 20, 15 plus 19. What is 15 plus 19? Yes, 34, correct. So 34 divided by 2 is what? 17. So class mark is 17. Now come to second class. 20 plus 24. What is that? 20 plus 24. Yes, 44. Then divide by 2. Yes. Now 25 plus 29. Divide by 2. Yes. So in this way, we will get class mark. So there is a formula for class mark. Class mark is represented by XI. Okay. Class mark is represented by X symbol XI. Lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. Okay. In the class 20 and 24, which is the lower limit? Class 20 and 24, which is the lower limit? Okay. Which is the upper limit? Okay. Okay. So you understood what is the lower limit and what is the upper limit? Class mark. Okay. Okay. Next. We are going to see what is the difference between the grouped and ungrouped data. Okay. We will see what is the grouped data and ungrouped data. So let's see what is the difference between the grouped data and ungrouped data. Classification. Organized into classes, grouped. Organized into classes, no form of organization. Okay. Preference. Preferred when analyzing data. For analyzing data. Preferred when collecting data. And in group accuracy. See what is the accuracy in group data. Has higher accuracy level when calculating mean and median. But when there is ungrouped, then it is less accurate in determining mean and median. Regarding the presentation, in group, the presentation of frequency tables are mostly used. And for ungrouped, lists are used in this data type. Summary. In the group, summarized in frequency distribution, no form of summarization. So you should know what is the difference between the group data and ungrouped data. Is it clear? Why we are learning group data? And up to 8th or 9th standard, we have learned something ungrouped data also. Correct? 8th and 9th, we have learned ungrouped data also. But in the 10th standard, you are going to learn group data. Okay? So these points should be remembered in the group data. Classification, preference, accuracy, presentation, summary. In the group, classification organized into classes, preference preferred when analyzing data is present, accuracy has higher, and presentation in a frequency table, summary summarized in frequency distribution. Okay. So today we are going to see mean. Okay. As we know that, what we know, there are three methods to find the mean. Okay. How many methods is there to find the mean? How many methods? Yes, they have. Three methods is there. So what are that method? Direct method to find the mean. Assume mean method. Step deviation method. These are the three methods. Again, I'm repeating. Direct method. Assume mean method. And step deviation method. These are the three methods to find the mean. Okay. But this year we are going to use only direct method to find the mean. Okay. Is it clear? Let's see what is direct method. Okay. So you are ready? Take pen, pencil, and note down how we are going to solve the direct method. Okay. Again, I'm repeating. Or you can take the screenshot also. In direct method, four column is present. In direct method, four column is present. First column contains class interval. What does the first column contains? Class interval. Okay. And that is given. Second column contains class mark. So now you know what is class mark. Correct? Which is represented by xi. So xi is equal to lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. And third column contains frequency. That is also given. Okay. So what we have to find in this? We have to find fourth column, that is product of xi, xi. Xi and fi. Product means multiplication of xi, fi. Xi is the class mark, fi is the frequency. So remember this in direct method, how many columns are present? How many columns are present? Yes. In first column, what is present? Class interval. Correct. And it is given. Okay. In second column, third column, yes. In fourth column, yes. So in first column, class interval is present, which is given. Second column contains class marks. Third column contains frequency. And fourth column contains product of xi, fi. Is it clear? So we have two column, out of four column, two column is given. That is class interval and frequency. Most of the time it is given. Most of the time it is given. And we have to find only class mark and product of xi, fi. Is it clear? Up to here, it is clear? Sure. Okay. So let's see what is the formula to find mean in direct method. Okay. Formula to find mean in direct method. So mean is equal to x bar. Mean is equal to x bar is equal to sum of xi fi upon sigma xi fi upon sigma fi. Is it clear? I will write here presentation. Wait, huh? Sigma fi xi upon sigma fi. Is it clear? That is the mean. Okay. Now we should know this sigma is also called as a summation, means sum of frequencies. Fi, sigma fi means sum of frequencies. We can write n also. Sigma fi is equal to n. Sigma fi is equal to n means sum of frequency. We have to add all the frequencies and we have to represent sigma fi. Is it clear? And when we add the sum of the product of fi xi, then we will say sigma fi xi. Okay. Is equal to sum of the product of fi xi. This two summation is required in direct method. This two summation is required. One is the sum of frequency, another is the sum of the product of fi xi. So this two summation required in direct method. And then formula is there. So you have to put that formula in that. Okay, is it clear? Sure. I wanted everyone have understood. Okay. If you understood, then tell na you have understood. So let one question we will take. Whether you understood or not, we will check it. Okay. Most of the students have written that they understood. Okay. So we will take one example. See here. Mean is equal to x bar is equal to sigma xi fi upon sigma fi. Okay. Now, we will take one example. The percentage of marks of 50 students in test is given in the following table. Okay. Suppose some students' marks are given in the form of table, because in 10th standard you are giving a lot of exams. Okay. So for 50 students, we have considered 50 students have given the exam and their marks are arranged in a table. Okay, let's see what is the percentage of the marks. 0 to 20 only got 3 students. 0 to 20. Okay, sometimes some students have failed also. Na? They are not writing, they don't like max, they are not practicing, they think that they will do it from here and there. So percentage of marks from 0 to 20, number of students, 3. And 20 to 40, 7. Okay. 40 to 60, 15. 60 to 80, 20 students. And 80 to 100, 5 students. Means the marks obtained between 80 to 100, there are 5 students. And the marks obtained from 60 to 80, there are 20 students. So where you are fine in this? I want to know in which class you are fine, in which class interval you are finding. Sanskriti also have written 80 to 100. Good. Sanskriti. Yes. Drishti. Diksha. Neha. Khushi. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Dhamesh, Siddesh, Neha. Okay? Enough? Only this much student? Okay, Bhumi also. Samyak. Swam. Okay. Krish. Okay, Sakshi, Shreya. Okay, very good. So, all want to come in 80s and 100. Okay, that is group 80 to 100. It is very good that you are aim high. So, let's see how this will solve. Okay, class interval, we know that we will write in four columns. That is class, which is given in a percentage form. So 0 to 20, 20 to 40, 40 to 60, 60 to 80, and 80 to 100. 80 to 100. Okay. Now we have to find out class mark. Okay. Tell me, what is the class mark of 0 to 20? 20 to 40. 40 to 60. Fast. Diksha, Chavan. Okay. 60 to 80. 8200. Okay, very good. Okay, so to find the class mark, we know that lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. So first class is 0 plus 20 means 20, and 20 divided by 2 is 10. Correct? 20 plus 40 is 60, and 60 divided by 2 is 30. Correct? 40 plus 60, 100. 100 divided by 2, 50. 60 plus 80 is equal to 140. And 140 divided by 2 is what? 70. 80 plus 100, 180. 180 divided by 2 is 90. Okay, now we know that class mark xi is equal to 10, 50, 70 and 90. Is it clear? Is it clear? Okay, let's see what is the frequency. So you can write down that frequency 3, 7, 15, 20, 5. Now add this frequency, add it. As I told you, you have to write in, you can write as a N, capital N, which is equal to summation of Fi. So when you add this 3 plus 7, 10, 10 plus 15, 25 plus 20 plus 5, 25, 50. Correct? So we get N is equal to 50. Now class mark into frequency. Class mark into frequency. So who will multiply first? 10 into 3. Write fast. 10 into 3. Okay. 30 into 7. 30 into 7, 50 into 15, write fast, 50 into 15, 70 into 20, 70 into 20, now 90 into 5. Okay, so when we multiply 10 into 3, that is 30, 30 into 7, that is 210, 50 into 15, 50 into 15, 1515, that is 750, 70 into 2, that is 1400, and 90 into 5, that is 450. Add it now. 30 plus 210 plus 750 plus 1400 plus 450. Write it fast. So sigma xi fi is equal to 2840. What is that? 2840. Okay. So we know what is sigma fi xi and what is sigma fi. So what is mean now? What is the form of mean? Mean is equal to sigma fi xi upon sigma fi. Correct? Yes, let's see now. Mean is equal to sigma fi xi upon sigma fi. Now substitute the value. What was sigma fi xi? 2840. And divide by sigma fi. Correct? Is it clear? Yes or no? So which is equal to 2840 upon 50 divide 00 will cancel. Now divide by 5. Is it clear? Yes. What is the answer now? Yes. When 284 is divided by 5, we'll get 56.8. So we will write as, therefore, the mean of the percentage is 56.8. Is it clear? Sure. 100%. So let's start practice at 6.1. Okay. In that one question is there. Two question is there. Question number one and question number three. So one question I will solve. The following table shows the measure, number of students and time they utilize daily for their studies. Yes. Now you are at home. So you should, how you are studying. I got the data collected, okay, via some sources. So how many hours you are studying, that we will see. Okay. The following that table shows the number of students and the time they are utilizing daily for their studies. Find the mean time spent by students for their studies by direct method. Let's see what is given. Time. 0 to 2 hours. Now, 0 to 2 hours, how many students are studying? 7. 2 to 4 hours, how many students are studying? 18. And 4 to 6 hours, how many students are studying? 12. 6 to 8, 10 students. And 8 to 10, 3 students. Okay. So let's see class interval, class mark, frequency, class mark into frequency. So class mark is given, frequency is given, that you have to write as it is. Class mark, you have to know how to find 0 plus 2 divided by 2. That is 1, 2 plus 4, that is 6, divided by 2, that is 3, 4 plus 6, 10, 10 divided by 2, 5, 6 plus 8. 14 divided by 2, 7, 8 plus 10, 18 divided by 2, that is 9. So it is a class mark. Okay. Now frequency is given. You have to write as it is. Now we have to find out FIXI. Okay. So 1 into 7 is 7, 3 into 18. 3 into 18 is what? 54. 5 into 12, 60. 7 into 10. 70, 9 into 3, 27. Now you have to add frequency as well as class mark to frequency. Both you have to add separately. When we are adding the frequency, we are getting 7 plus 18 plus 12 plus 10 plus 3, which is equal to 50. Okay. And when we are adding FIXI, 7 plus 54. Plus 60, plus 70, plus 27, we will get 280. Now we are going to use the formula. Is it clear? We are going to use the formula. Mean is equal to x bar is equal to sigma xi fi upon sigma fi, which is equal to 280 upon 15. We have to substitute the value. 218 upon 50. Now divide it first. Divide by 5 and then move 1 point to the left. Okay. Divide by 5 and then move 1 point to the left. Is it clear? So when we divide 218 by 5, so we will get 43.6 hours. So one point will move to the left side. That is 4.36. Is it clear? We have divided it. Share. Yes. So see, 4.36 hours. So this we found the mean time spent by the student for their studies. Okay. So we can write like this way. Hence, the mean time spent by the student for their studies. For their studies. Okay. Now, as in 6.1, only two questions is there. One question I have solved for you. Okay. I think up to here, everyone understood properly. Share. Okay. Good.